which is already available. So, and that we can install onto the Android as well as Apple phone, this thing, iOS. So that is taken care, so you need not worry now. So that I will be telling in the Unix lecture, Unix this thing. So now we shall begin. First unit, we are going to see at operating system overview. So what are the functions of the operating system? So let us first thing what we'll see a few things which as we are using the operating system from your childhood, you are using the operating system, right? So from your perspective, what is the operating system? What is the operating system for you as a user of the operating system? Johan, Stephen?
Ma'am, it's a software that connects the user to the hardware of a system.
It is a software that connects, yeah. Okay. Anybody else correct? Huh? Anybody else? How will you define as, and because you already use this software, right? You are user of the, we are user of the software. So, Srishti? Prarthana?
Yes, ma'am.
Not necessary definition. What operating system for is for you? Because
it is an interface, ma'am, like between the user and the machine.
User and the hardware. Okay, correct. We know that is what is this operating system is. So it is an interface, as she said, it is an interface. So if we have a very good hardware, I have a supercomputer, and I have a huge amount of RAM, I have a very big hard disk and so on. But if the operating system is not there, then can I use those things? If I have a very good processor, I have a latest processor, but I don't have a operating system. So shall I use that processor?
No, ma'am.
We cannot use. So what is the operating system plays a very important role whenever, not only in terms of the, for the machines or the desktops, even all the devices like mobile, then any embedded systems, real-time systems, operating system plays an important role. So as the hardware progresses, there has to be a compatible operating system which is taking care of or which is coping up with those advancement in the hardwares. Even for the small embedded systems, there are we put a sensors. We take the data from them and then we take the decision. At that time, at that places also we need a kind of operating system to take to interact with the hardware, because without the operating system, the interaction with the hardware is not possible. So, for example, you have executed Python programs, C programs, C++, Java, and so on, all these programs. So, as a software engineer, does the operating system plays a role for us? As we are a program writer, we write a program, or we develop a program, or we develop a software, does it help us as well? From the application perspective, yes. If somebody want to automate their grocery store, or want to launch something online, for everything they need an operating system. Without operating system, nothing is possible. The same way, as a software engineer, for a program writer or a developer as well, what we need is, so whether it is a layman, that is no, it's a person who is maybe child or a non-technical person, needs an operating system, as well as we, as an engineer, we also need an operating system to develop other softwares. So without operating system, the hardwares, RAM, nothing is of use. It cannot be used. So A program that acts as an intermediary between user of a computer and the computer hardware. So operating system, it is a works as a kind of a translator. Operating system works like a translator for us. It is a translator for us. On behalf of us, it will be talking to the hardware. Sorry, I was closing the door. So without operating system,
you cannot. Ma'am, direct second year students are waiting to join.
Acha, waiting.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, they have joined. So without operating system, even we cannot work for developing something. So for developing something, I need to write something. I need to develop a software. What I need is, I need to choose some system software. So there is a category of softwares called as an application softwares and the system softwares. System softwares are the softwares which help us to develop another software. So for example, Turbo C compiler or Java interpreter, Java virtual JVM machine, then Python, whatever you need for executing those things, that all things comes under what? System software, because which allows you to develop by making use of those. We make the other softwares or the other develop other applications which are specific to particular applications. So these softwares which help us to develop another softwares are called as system softwares. And the application softwares are specific to application, like Word is one of the application for manipulating the text documents. Then Excel is another the application for the managing the text as well as numerical and this kind of data, tabular data. So these are the application, and we can have so many applications like games and so many. So what are the goals of the operating system? It allows us to execute user programs and make solving user problems easier. So initially, before this operating system, this generation operating system which we are working, before that people used to had very tough time because there was no operating system. So they had to submit their this thing. They used to write programs in a COBOL or some languages before that, or even machine languages, then submit, write it onto the tape drives, like punch cards and all, and then submit it. And then they used to execute it. So that way. Now, because the operating system is so advanced, now we create so many instances of like a Google Chrome, Excel sheet I can open 10 at a time, and Word I can open so many things I can open at a time. So this who allows?
Ma'am.
Is there anybody waiting? Yeah, 1 second. All the direct admitted students are inside now?
No, ma'am. My friend Ajit is waiting for your acceptance.
Ajit, just allowed him. I admitted him.
Okay, ma'am.
So because of the operating system, we can do this. And this kind of operating system right now, which we are working with, are called as a multi-user, multitasking, or the multi-program operating system. Because we, someone more, again, I admitted already. Now Ajit is inside, Multi-tasking operating system. So operating system's goal, in the goal, it should allow us to execute program. As an execute program from the developer's perspective, like a Turbo C, and then where I write a program, then I create another application. So that is one perspective. Another perspective is from the application perspective, if it is a grocery shop or somebody want to do something, and it allows us to, unless and until we do not click a program or the application icon, it is operating, it is, the program is not in a running state, or we cannot use that application. So, and who allows this? This allows, operating system allows us not to run any application, because whenever any application we are saying that it has to be executed, it has to be in a running state, that time that application should be present in the host primary memory. And that usually whenever we install softwares, where we install by default, you install in a C drive or D drive, you put somewhere. So these drives are what secondary memories, and those are the permanent memories. But when I say the application has to be executed, that time it is of no use having the application residing onto the secondary memory. It has to be in the RAM, then and then only those instructions can be executed by the CPU. And that is why, who does this? Bringing the application from the secondary device to the main memory, whenever you are clicking a Chrome, suppose, or Excel sheet or a Word, the operating system will be bringing that wherever that application is residing, maybe in a C drive or a D drive, wherever it is, it brings that application along with the dependencies of that application in the RAM. So that is how it allows us to execute the program. Second is, its goal is to make the computer system convenient to use. And then third one is, use the computer hardware in an efficient manner, because the computer hardware is you have a best hardware, but the operating system is not best, cannot utilize that capability potential of the hardware, then it is of no use. So these are the goals of the operating system. Now, the what is the base of this thing? Computer system is hardware. We should have in the hardware what we have, kind of processor you need, we need a memory, then we need input and output devices. So we need to give something to process, and then somebody has to process it, and somewhere we need to keep it temporarily, so that we need a RAM, and then after processing that, we need to put it back again, result. So that could be I/O. So I/O could be a monitor, it could be files, input as well could be taking from the file, opening the file, managing those files, and writing back again into the file, or maybe onto the monitor, or input devices could be taking something from the keyboard and doing some processing and putting onto the monitor. So anything. Then operating system is responsible for controlling, coordinating between the hardware and the various application, because we have a one keyboard. So can you type at the Google, can you give simultaneously, can you type in the Google for, you are want to give search for something for searching, and in the word processing as well, both your applications are open. So can you do that? At a time, both places, can you type?
No, ma'am.
We cannot, and that is who is providing that facility, because we open, and that is operating system is doing coordinating that everything. This controlling, who actually, we say alt tab, and we copy from here or whatever we do, and we switch from one application to the another application, and then it is taking care of where it should go. It is never done a mistake, right? You might have seen. We may do mistake, but the operating system will take care of everything, controlling and managing all this. Okay. Then, like application programs are like here, already we spoke about the word processors, compilers, and this thing. Then, different kind of users like nav users, technical, highly technical users, and on. So on. So based on the expertise, the perspective looking at the operating system is definitely will change. So if we the components are this way. Hardware lies at the bottom layer, then the operating system, then the system softwares and the application softwares. So system, under system software, compilers, assemblers, text editors, and so many things goes. And the application are a bit, little bit this thing above onto that. Like some editors are, as we use the Turbo C editor, as well as which is a combination of all. It is a compiler, it is editor, everything. So sometimes compiler is below editor. Sometimes in a, now this time we'll be doing program C program on a Linux platform. That time we will realize there is no editor comes with a Turbo C compiler. There we have to go to the command prompt and execute C program, and not like the way we had done in a, on a Windows platform. This was the like goals of the operating system, or operating system what it does for us. It does these are the things which it takes care of. Now the concept of a process. All of you might have faced a problem. Sometimes your machine, laptop might have hanged, and what you did is you may press Alt, Control, Delete, and you go to the task editor, task manager, and you say end task, and then you could see that you have opened only one or two applications, maybe like a browser or some other application. But when you go to the end task, hello, have I shared my screen or I forgot?
No, ma'am.
Oh my god, so you are not telling up till now. So sorry, and I was going, I don't know how I forgot, but now I realized that is why it is not coming as in stop sharing and all. I'm so extremely sorry. But you should tell me, no? So this was the first part we covered. Okay, so this was we saw, and then we are here, and the process management. One of the another objective of the main purpose of the, now is it visible? Process management. So now what is a process? A process is a program under execution or in execution. It is a unit of work within a system. Program, now we have written a program. So take an example of a stack.c. So this is a program where you saved this. So you might have saved this program on a C drive or a D drive under your student, some name like Aditya, and in that you might have saved your all C programs, right? So those are you are saving for a permanent purpose, like it is permanently there. Now if you want to run that program, so that program and the process, what is the difference between the program and the process? So now suppose stack.c, I want to execute, then what I do is I go to the Turbo C compiler, I open it, I open that particular file which I want to run. Now first I see whether it is there, it's error free. So what I do is I compile it, and after compilation, what we do, if it is successfully compiled, then what we do is we run it. Now when we run it, that time that program is converted into process. Otherwise that program is a passive entity which is lying there onto the hard disk, which is not consuming any resources. Whereas the process, when that particular program is, I am running, when I'm saying run it or execute it, that time it is going to take the system's resources. Now what kind of resources it is going to take? It is going to take a memory, it is going to take CPU time, and it is going to take IO. All the resources it will be using as per the need. Is it clear the difference between the process and the program? Whatever Python program, Java program, whatever the program we write, we save it onto the hard disks for a permanent purpose. Next time I want to use it, I want to again edit it and do. But the program, when I'm saying execute, that time that program will be converted into a process, and that is why process is a active entity and the program is a passive entity. Why it is active entity? Because it is consuming the resources. It is engaging the resources for its purpose, it, for the for executing its instruction. Is it clear, the concept of a process?
Clear, ma'am. Got the difference.
Yeah. Process needs, so CPU, this I spoke about. Then sometimes initialization is required. Now, whenever this resources process will be taking for a temporary, because once our program finishes its execution, it comes back to the editor, right? So we'll take example of a C or Java, whichever right now you are doing. So that is not an issue, but it releases the resources and then again it becomes. So process are what? Temporarily program is converted into process, and once it is finished its task, then it will return CPU, it will return the memory, it will return the keyboard and monitor, everything. It will release everything, files and everything. So it is temporarily acquire the resources and give it back. So the operating system is the software which is allocating these resources to different processes. What I was talking before, when I forgot to share the screen, I was talking about the task manager. So you might have opened maximum 10 application, but have you observed that when you go to say end task, that there you might have seen the more than 50 tasks which you have not initialized or you have not started the applications. Have you seen, observed this?
Yes, ma'am, background running task.
Background running task. So these background running tasks in nothing but the operating systems, system calls are the very urgent processes which are running for us, or the operating system itself. There are a few things in detail we are going to see ahead. So that is application. Other than the applications which we are opening, there are some applications or the some system softwares or the softwares which are by default running, like keeping the keyboard ready is the job of operating system. Before we boot the machine, it checks. It takes booting is not like switching on the fan, right? Switching on the laptop or the desktop takes little bit time. Is it similar to the switching of your fan? Is it similar to switching off your fan? Switching off or on your fan? Yes or no?
No.
It is no, because quickly you cannot see your machine is ready. So the operating, so why it is so? So when it is we switch on, when we say start, after that something somebody does, and that is called as an what? Booting process. That we call it as booting process. And who does it and why it is required? Because there is a software which we call it as an operating system, which needs to be there in a main memory, and that always you might have installed many times software or operating systems on your machines, and you know that operating systems are residing where? On C drive or some drive, that means on a secondary memory. And when you start your machine, that time the operating system, is the operating system already there in the RAM? Do you think the operating system is there in the RAM?
Yes.
No, when we start the machine, operating system is not there in the RAM. Before the operating system, there are BIOS routines. There are what? BIOS routines which will check. आपको लाइट दिखता है, माउस के लिए यहाँ पे रेड क्लिक होता है, देन कीबोर्ड के लिए क्लिक होता है, एंड देन मशीन रेडी हो जाता है. सो दोस बायस रूटीन्स चेक्स कि पूरा हार्डवेयर सब है और प्रॉपरली कनेक्टेड है, एवरीथिंग इज देयर, आईओ डिवाइसेस, हार्ड डिस्क सही है एंड एवरीथिंग. सो दैट इज बायस रूटीन्स. कि जो बायस इज लाइक इट इज अ फर्मवेयर, कि जो हार्डवेयर भी है वो सॉफ्टवेयर में, बट इट इज software what we say we can erase, and then we keep on erasing and keep on writing it again, but the BIOS routines are wo fix hai hardware mein, matlab kuch memory locations pe, ek fix location pe wo fix hai, and those are the things which will be checking this everything, system ready hai ki nahi hai, jo ki fan ke case mein
it is like a battery na, looks like battery.
It looks like a battery because वो हाँ चीप ही होता है वो, like मतलब what you can say कि fixed instruction जो fixed डाला हुआ है, that is BIOS इसमें firmware में, it is not a software, it is not a hardware, or you can say it is matlab fix kiya hai usko, isliye that we call it as an firmware. दिखने में तो एज एन हार्डवेयर मतलब कुछ तो कंपोनेंट में ही है, वो एक चिप में ही होता है वो, ठीक है, मतलब कहीं ना कहीं. इट इज नॉट अ लाइक अ बैटरी, इट इज नॉट अ बैकअप काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग, इट इज द दोज आर द सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस कि जो उसको हम लोग बायस रूटीन बोलते हैं, कि जो बायस इनपुट आउटपुट बेसिक इनपुट आउटपुट ऑफ सिस्टम का जो ये है वो चेक करता है बिफोर लोडिंग द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इन टू द रैम. मतलब ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम रैम में आने के पहले ही वो सब करता है, तो इसको व्हाट वी कॉल इट एज बूटिंग प्रोसेस. फिर देयर इज अ वन एड्रेस, देयर इज अ वन एड्रेस, वो बायस रूटीन में ही होता है. दैट एड्रेस दैट गिव्स इट हैज द एड्रेस कि ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम कहाँ से शुरू होता है, एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर एड्रेस वो खुद से ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम फिर खुद को इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ लोडर, ठीक है, वो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को लोड करना शुरू कर देता है. एंड देन ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इट टेक्स फ्यू सेकेंड्स टू लोड द टू ब्रिंग द फ्रॉम द सेकेंडरी मेमोरी टू द रैम. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम फिर रैम में आ जाता है, एंड देन इट टेक्स फ्यू सेकेंड्स आपका सिस्टम फिर रेडी हो जाता है. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एक बार रेडी होने के बाद, मतलब हमेशा के लिए ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम रैम में नहीं होता है. इज दिस क्लियर?
यस.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So these are the we are going to cover in detail. What is multi-threading, multi-processing, concurrency, and all. This is another, like if there are, as I said, there are 50s or 100s of the processes. That means अपने पास keyboard and monitor तो एक ही है, and but there are so many processes. तो उसका coordination definitely कुछ conflict नहीं होना चाहिए. So who takes care of this? Operating system takes care of all of these things under process coordination or inter-process communication. अपने पास CPU भी एक या दो होते हैं, तो even that is also shared resources. तो that resources also conflict ना कभी भी नहीं आता है. Like ऐसे कोई भी process आपको कभी नहीं दिखता है क्या कि they is saying that the CPU इसने ले लिया है मुझे नहीं मिल रहा है. No, operating system is managing everything without knowing, without we will not recognize that it is doing behind. So that way, that systematically it does everything. Now, what are the process management? With respect to the process management, what are the activities OS does? OS is responsible for creating and deleting the user processes as well as the system processes. Operating system is responsible for creating and deleting user process as well as system processes. Then suspending and resuming the processes. Then providing mechanism for process synchronization. Why synchronization is required? When I am typing in a word, so keyboard word application se connected kiya hai. Who does this? Operating system does it. Now I want to type at the same time I want to Google something. Then immediately just I say alt tab and go to the Google and browser and put something, that time the same keyboard will be given to whom? The another different process, and that is the process for the which application? Browser. And again there will be so many browsers terminal I might have opened, but the whichever under right now active, for that only keyboard will be given. So this synchronization among so many processes is the major task of the operating system. Operating system has to take care of that. मैंने एक फाइल में मुझे डालना है और वो दूसरे फाइल में गया, दूसरे एप्लीकेशन में गया, नहीं. It should not happen like that. Then providing the communication, synchronization as well as the communication. Sometimes we need to one process produces the data and the second process takes that data and process that data. So the both has to be properly. And both has to communicate properly, and that again operating system does. And the last is the deadlock handling. Deadlock handling is one process. Deadlock will come into the depth of a deadlock. There are some algorithms we are going to study. Deadlock. Just right now we can conceptually we can say if it is a one way and you are driving and you went to half of the way, and from the other side as well, the wrong side, another vehicle have come. Now the other vehicle cannot proceed further, and you also cannot further proceed further unless and until one of you you have to go back. And this particular situation is called as a deadlock. So in case of the operating system, or in case of the CPU processes and all, so this kind of a situation comes, and if such kind of a situation comes, then the processes will not proceed further, and that particular situation is called as a deadlock situation. So IC situation, and this is situation many times somehow we handle by all control units and task manager mein jaake dead, matlab you kill the processes and you come out of that deadlock. So that way you might have handled before. Some place void noise is coming. Then second objective of the operating system is a memory management. First is the process management, then memory management. In the case memory management, as I said, operating system khud bhi memory mein nahi hota hai. So memory management, it is related to the primary memory. Theek hai? So the operating system ko koi to memory mein, like RAM mein, somebody brings it. So to wo BIOS routine wahan pe jo address hota hai, then wo loader it brings operating system ka, not full part, some part, and then operating system ka the other part it fetches itself, so that way it itself comes completely. Now memory, in the memory management, as I gave example of that stack.c resides on the C drive or a D drive. When I want to execute it, it has to be there in a memory. So then stack जिस डेटा पे काम करने वाला है, सो दैट डेटा आल्सो नीड्स टू बी इन अ मेमोरी. एंड नाउ द इंस्ट्रक्शंस, सो माय सी प्रोग्राम हैज टू बी देयर इन अ मेमोरी. नाउ माय मशीन सीपीयू इज नॉट गोइंग टू एग्जीक्यूट माय सी इंस्ट्रक्शंस, दोज इंस्ट्रक्शंस हैज टू बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू मशीन लेवल लैंग्वेज. सो व्हाट द व्हेन वी कंपाइल अवर प्रोग्राम, व्हाट हैपेंस इज द ऑब्जेक्ट कोड डॉट ओबीजे फाइल, सपोज नाउ देन यू after this lecture you can compile one program, C program. Then after, if it is successfully compiled, then what you do is, if suppose that name is stack.c, then you check whether stack.obj file, also you try to open stack.obj file, object file will be created, and that is nothing but the assembly code of the C, directly C instructions, because C is a higher level language, the CPU is not going to execute. Our processor is going to execute only limited amount of instruction set. Har ek processor ka fix rehta hai, like instruction set jo hai only fix rehta hai, and based on that hum log advanced instructions banate hai higher level languages mein. So those instruction, whatever we do in higher level language, has to be converted into lower level. Theek hai? And those lower level instructions, so कंपाइलर के बाद आप कंपाइलर क्रिएट्स ऑब्जेक्ट कोड, देन हम लोग जो stdio.h stdio.h या std जो भी है maths.h एंड सो ऑन, जो हम लोग आप लोग जो इंक्लूड करते हो फाइल्स, दोज फाइल्स हैज टू बी देयर इन द मेमोरी दैट टाइम. तो ये सब कौन ला के, हु ब्रिंग्स इट इन अ मेमोरी, देयर इज आफ्टर कंपाइलेशन बिफोर एग्जीक्यूशन देयर इज अ लोडर who loads all the required files into the RAM. Okay, so the memory management, and now there are many applications in the RAM na, like browser bhi open hai, like copy bhi karna hai na mujhe kahin se, I have to copy, I have to make a document, word bhi open hai, then I have a MatterBox and some other applications as well running, mera python e bhi ready hai, chal raha hai, and so on. So memory management, what is the role of the operating system here? One process should not write into other's memory, and that is why the operating system plays a very important role in memory management, because there are multiple processes running and one process should not interfere into the other's area, and that is who does operating system. That is what my memory man one data has to be operating system जो भी process आ रहे हैं अंदर the वो process का instructions data has to be there in a RAM. Second thing is memory management determine memory when and it has to be optimized optimum way it has to be utilized. How much is required? Then where to put? Where is the free memory? Where is the allocated memory? One should not OS should not write into the already allocated memory. So that is the things. That is the functions we'll be studying in detail today. Now we are going to just look at the what the operating system does. One it does is the process management activities. Second it does is the memory management activities. Third it does process storage management. Now the storage management is nothing but the secondary memories, which is your C drive, D drive, your pen drive, then your floppy disks, your CD drives, and all these things. So more to the naming, the drives, and then making the allowing the creation of the files, folders, the hierarchy of those folders, and everything. जो भी maintained रहते हैं, that is also operating systems. Memory management is different. It is completely related with at the time of execution RAM कैसे use करना है. Storage management is completely different, which is telling us about the permanent storage. RAM is a temporary storage. So creation of the folders, files, then the manipulation of the files, directories. Then backup, taking backup, sometimes अगर कुछ हो जाता है then उसके लिए जो भी है everything is taken care by the operating system. Then mass storage as well. Mass storage that is come for the huge amount of data जो कि storage के मतलब we are generating nowadays huge amount of data ना तो कहीं ना कहीं वो data चला ही जा रहा है so that storage also has to be taken care by the operating system. And other than the hard disks and all, there are different kind of a storage that we call it as a mass storage because data is a huge. But to access that data, ultimately again we need an operating system. Without that, we cannot do. In the mass storage, again all management, disk scheduling algorithms and everything we will see. So ideally we can say categorize the functions of the operating system related to the process management, memory management, secondary this management, and IO input output device management as well. So that is here I forgot to mention input output device management also is the one of the important function of the operating system. Operating system, so see RAM, if it is visible because it is cropped image. First layer it is hardware, and you can see that there are device drivers. Device drivers are the components which will be interacting with the hardware. Then comes the operating system, device drivers, then some system programs, and then the application programs. This layered approach in the Linux lecture we are going to see this approach because Linux Unix is the operating system which is a based on the layered architecture. Layer 0 pe hardware hota hai, layer 1 pe kernel hota hai, and so on. So ye this is now I won't speak much about it because we'll be covering in the first lab. Then Mac OS is the operating system which is designed on the basis of the microkernel. Microkernel means a very small kernel or the functionality which is a mandatory functionality which is kept as small as possible, and that is why microkernel. And the next approach is which is a Solaris operating system is which is a module wise operating system. Operating system is divided into modules like scheduling classes, file system is a different module, loadable system calls is a different module, executable formats is a different module, then devices, IO devices, device drivers, these are the different modules.
Noise is coming from my side.
Yeah, it was from. So that way, the operating system, designing the operating system, these are the different approaches. Layered approach, modular approach, this is called as a modular approach. This Linux one is this approach, then microkernel. Microkernel is keeping the kernel very small. So next lecture, we'll be looking at the kernel and all. Just today, we'll finish it off. Two things only. How the OS and today's modern operating systems are the interrupt driven. Interrupt driven means, as I said, you just you type something, you hit a particular key, wo key aapke cams mein aa jata hai, wo application mein. So whenever we are hitting the key, that is we are creating the interrupt, or it is a operating system works in a.
Am I audible? Because my headphone is giving some noise.
Ma'am, you are audible.
Operating system works. This operate nowadays. Modern operating systems are interrupt driven operating systems, and which works in a two modes. Now, two modes are user mode and the kernel mode or system mode. Now, operating system, whenever there are system processes, as you specified, the background processes, those are the system processes or processes which are operating system ko lagta hai, wo processes hai. So those processes or the calls will be executed in which mode? Those are privileged. मतलब उसको ज्यादा priority है. Like priority क्यों पड़ा है ना हम लोगों ने. So अगर system call और user call अगर दो waiting में है तो who will get the priority? System call will get the priority. So the operating system always works in a two modes. It is called in a dual mode, user mode and this thing. So user process भी है. So if I want to open some application and enter something, so that application will be open as an user process, and then if it is taking some input from the keyboard, then operating system will change its mode to kernel mode or a system mode. Then it will it will change its mode and take the input from the keyboard and give it back and change the again mode into back to the user mode. So and trap is a hard software interrupt. Trap is a software interrupt jo ki it is used for changing these modes. Zero is for kernel mode. It will be set to zero to execute any this thing in a kernel mode or a system mode, and if whenever it is one, then the processes are executing in which mode? In the user mode, or those are having the less priorities or privileges, whereas the system is executing. So related with the hardware, all the device drivers, the interconnection between, if my application is talking to the keyboard or to the monitor, I need a driver. That means I will be typing, I don't know what inside is happening, but the operating system is changing without knowing us, this kernel mode, user mode to the kernel mode and all. It is taking care of all those things, and the OS internally works like that. And that is why we do not, like, we cannot damage, because some processes, for IO processes and all, those are running in the system mode. So whenever, just for taking the input, it will be turning that mode and it allows the input. Immediately it goes back to the user process mode. So having the less privileges. So what we saw is how operating system functions. Operating system, these architectures are layered architecture, modular architecture, microkernel architecture. These are the design, matlab what how to design operating system. Design operating system is a very complicated software which will be taking care of the memory management, file system, file management, IO devices, and CPU scheduling and process management. These are the things it will be doing, and that is why it is a bulky software, and that is why some kind of approach we need to follow. So what are the possibilities? Are layered ki hardware niche rakho, then layered, next layer system software as Unix jaisa hai, so that way. Then modular, Solaris is the operating system feature. It has divided operating system functions into modules. They have adopted that modular approach. But jo DOS tha, like previous operating system, very old operating system, that was micro kernel nahi, isme kernel bahut thick tha. Theek hai? Then the Mac OS is the following the micro kernel approach. Micro kernel in the Mac OS, the micro kernel approach in the sense kernel, the minimum requirement jo hai, wo kernel mein hai. So kernel size becomes smaller. So these are the approaches of what designing or writing operating system. So what is time? It's 36. So is there any doubt till now?
Ma'am, I want